items in your bill is that the mother would choose. Have you thought about a situation in which she doesn't want to choose?
Yeah, actually, that's also addressed in the bill, or excuse me, to the chair, to the ranking member. That's also addressed in the bill. There is a section in there that says that if a reasonable time has passed since the procedure took place and the mother has not made a decision, then the abortion provider may make that decision.
And, yes, thanks for your time. And so, along those lines, you know, one of the things that I was concerned about when I first read about your bill was we go to great lengths with our HIPAA rules and you know, everything else for the confidentiality and the protections of all health information. I think it's one of the things that we've done a really good job in this country of making sure that people feel that their health information is kept confidential. They're the only ones that get to share it. Having some kind of a piece of legislation like this that requires a signature then really concerns me, because then I want to know where are the files kept, who has access to the files, and I know that you're aware, you know, that, that folks who are concerned about the constitutional right of a woman's access to choose an abortion if she chooses, that that they are very, you know, concerned about creating barriers towards their access. You've said in your testimony, you've said in your testimony that that's not what this is about. So how do you respond, though, to the concern that having someone sign a form and create a record might somehow be put there to really make some women, you know, be concerned about where that information ends up?
This question to the chair, to the ranking member, this question has come up, and as far as confidentiality of records, I do share your concerns with that, and I have made it clear before that there would be no mass turnover of these records to the Department of Health. The records would need to be kept in the event that just basically so there would be verification. I would be willing to put an amendment into the bill that would clarify that to make sure that, you know, we're not just turning over massive amounts of records to the government.
And I think too, if I may add, that what this bill does, it actually allows the abortion facility to create that form, and I, or maybe it's just a checkbox already on the forms that they provide. We're not adding additional forms to the process. It's up to the abortion facility to decide how they want to, you know, maybe it's, you know, a checkbox. It's really up to, it's their decision on how they would like to, you know, have the woman choose. Does that make sense?
The only thing I would add to that, Madam Chair, the ranking member, I'm a relatively healthy person, but we've had five kids, and my wife was in to have a baby, we signed kinds of forms, and I'm assuming that all that information is kept private as well, but there's many consent forms that we sign every time we go to the hospital.
Yes, Representative Damon, thank you. So, along the lines of what we're saying, part of what your bill does is create a fetal death certificate, I believe, and so one of the questions I have is, we've talked about the confidentiality of the form, but have you also thought about, or is there some kind of accommodation then for the additional cost to our records departments? And again, how will that information be stored? Will we be hiring additional folks? Where will the funds come from to be able to do this additional work on behalf of our statistics departments?
Well, I would say the death certificate issue is one thing that in existing law, in order to have a cremation or burial, you need a death certificate. So that's one thing that we created. And again, if it's a confidentiality issue, like I said, it's something that I would be willing to work on to make sure that that's still maintained.
Any other questions?
religious preferences, I started out going to pre-med, and some people have donated their body to science. So, you know, exceptions like that. Are there exceptions in other areas of the law when we're talking about final disposition?
As far as this bill is concerned, we are pretty well set on cremation and burial as the humane disposal. We feel that falls in line with the original intent of those laws that came about. Obviously, there's an ambiguity, otherwise we wouldn't have two sides that disagree on it. But that's what we feel satisfies the humane disposal.